कृतारि वञ्चने दृष्टिः येनाञ्जनमलीमसा अच्युताय नमस्तस्मै परमौचित्यकारिणि. लास्ट क्लास वी सॉ गुण औचित्यम एंड गुणगतम अनौचित्यम. देयर वाज जस्ट वन पॉइंट दैट आई वांट टू अगेन स्पेसिफाई विच I said it last time also, but this time also I'll say one more time as a recap. Just that guna is a technical term which in Alankara Shastram means it is the style or the way the poetry is written. There are 24 gunas or 4 or 5 gunas, principal 5 gunas. There are other gunas also, and in those it aids in rasam. Rasa utkarsha hetavaha gunaha, whereas doshaha are rasa apakarsha hetavaha. We don't have satyavaditvam or, you know, the character of a person in mind when you're reading the gunas here. So the guna auchityam is as per the rasa, whichever is appropriate, that guna has to be used in such a manner that it is appropriate in understanding the rasa that is being explained there, or the rasa that is being said there. Achulma,
gunamndrathu vandu epovume shabda taandi dhaan irukuma illa da ena reethi gunam vandu reethiyoda or component reethi vandu shabda base panni dhaan irukliya vritti reethi nu varcha so adanal gunamndrathu epovume shabda ipo vandu vaarthaigal evlo ad arthathukku onnu or idu kudukku
arthathula onnume illa anga. It is only based on shabda where you say whether it has in the words adavadhu mridu aksharangal iruka illa parisha aksharam iruka
eppadi pothirukkenradhu na parisha iruka
so samasa bhuyastvama prithak padatava appadi thane paathirukkom. So even the whether the meaning adada avar vandu he pointed out when he was talking about the anauchityam for guna, he said even though the artham is good during that and the yuddha adellam solrache artham nanna irukku, even the smara sanjwaraha karatala sparshehi na parikshyaha and all that, the artham is fine. In fact, in that he says the artha is not good. Actually it is the other one he says adladane and the bhagya chapaleshu name pratignya daivam niyachati jayam parajayam va. Even though the artham is fine, उचित अर्थ अभी अत्र क्षात्रवृत्ति इव ओजसा काव्यगुणेन अस्पृष्टा सुभटोक्ति उचितार्थ अभी. सो दैट इट्सेल्फ शोज दैट गुण इज नॉट बेस्ड ऑन अर्थम, इट इज ओनली बेस्ड ऑन शब्द लिया अंद अर्थंगल इज फाइन. But if the shabda is not reflective of the rasam, even though it is shabda based, it is, should be reflective of the rasam that it is trying to say, right? So adnala uchita artha api, the meaning is fine, meaning gives me that rasam, but the words also should reflect it. The words la vandu enna aidrathu oru nimisham anda veera rasatha enala rasikka mudiyada vadiki aidrathu, it just goes down there, illaya. So that makes it clear that guna is based on shabda. Now next he goes to alankaram. Here when he talks of alankara, he only gives, Kshemendra gives only the examples of upama in most of the places. You can talk of every alankara that has been said so far also, and auchityam is very important as far as what you use to compare or how you are expressing it. So alankara can be of two types. Again, it is a decoration of both the shabda and the artha. Shabda alankara is, I think he doesn't deal with shabda alankara, because any poet who dwells in shabda alankara is a kukavi or a person who only talks of adhama kavyam, right? It's just shabda chitram. Whereas he talks more of the artha alankaras. And he says even the alankara that you use should be used in a very appropriate manner. He says artha auchityavata suktihi alankarena shobhate peenastana sthitena iva harena harinekshana artha auchityavata alankarena suktihi shobhate. Suktihi, any kavyam or any shloka, shobhate, it is very beautiful if the अर्थ औचित्यवता अलङ्कारेण एव अलङ्कारेण सहिता उक्तिः एव शोभते. सो हौ शुड् दट् अलङ्कार बि दट् यु यूस् दि ऐदर् दि अर्थालङ्कार ओन्ली दि अर्थालङ्कार वि आर् टाकिङ्ग् अबौट् सो दि अर्थालङ्कार दट् यु आर् यूसिङ्ग् इन् दट् पोयम् शुड् हेव् एन् अर्थ औचित्यम् अर्थ औचित्यवता अलङ्कारेण दट् इट् सेल्फ् शोस् दट् क्षेमेन्द्र इस् टाकिङ्ग् ओन्ली अबौट् अर्थालङ्कारास् So the meaning with which the alankara is used should have a propriety in that. Okay. So prastuta arthasya auchityena upama utprekshadina alankarena. It should be in accordance. What should be the utpreksha, upama, etc. that we are using should be in accordance to the prastuta artha or the sandarbha, the contextual meaning. Then the suktihi chakasti, it is very beautiful. The example he gives here, he also uses an uchita alankaram here. Peenastana sthitena harena yatha harinekshana prakashate tatha. A lady is wearing a very beautiful haram, but if she is not wearing it in the proper place, then it is not good. That is one thing. Another thing, it should also be with a beautiful, peenastanasthitena harena. She also looks beautiful if she has that haram correctly nestling at that bosom. That is more important. So peenastanasthitena, just like how there should be artha auchityam, uchita stana pradesha. There the hara is placed. Then the Harinekshana, the girl with the beautiful eyes or doe-like eyes, she also, Chakasti, she is also beautiful. So Kamini Iva, 1 minute. Kamini Iva, Uccha Kucha Chumbina Ruchira Muktavali Kalapena Shobhate, Yatha Kamini Mukta Kalapena, Mukta Kalapena with a pearl necklace, which is beautiful, ruchira mukta kalapena, and it is just nestled, or chumbi means it is touching the atyuccha kucha, her breasts. So tatha kamini yatha chakasti, just like how she is beautiful, the same way with an artha auchityam, if you are using an alankara in a shlokam, then it is also beautiful. Example, the first example he takes is from Ratnavali. The entrance of it is, that is the, in the beginning itself, after the Praveshaka, you have Yogandharayana coming in, and he has to introduce the next character, right? When he introduces the Raja, the tone of the Natakam is, the king is a Dhira Lalita Nayaka. Dhira Lalita is a person who enjoys a lot. So the entrance itself, when he introduces the character of Vatsaraja, he introduces him as he compares him with the Manmatha and introduces him. The entrance of him itself, look at how the king is coming. Vatsaishwaraha kusumachapaiva abhyupeti. Raja is coming in like Manmatha, kusumachapaha iva abhyupeti. So Vishanta Vigraha Kato Ratiman Janasya. This is a Ratnavali is a Natakam written by Sriharsha. So Vishranta Vigraha Kato Ratiman Janasya Chitte Vasan Priya Vasantaka Eva Sakshat Paryutsukaha Nija Mahotsava Darshanaya Vatseshwaraha Kuzumachapa Iva Abhyupaiti. Here he says he gives the time when the drama is starting. So it is Vasantakala in tone with a natika, that is how a natika should be. It has just four ankas. Everything is said in this shloka, where he also talks of how the king is. He portrays the Dhira Lalita Nayaka very beautifully in the shloka also. And he talks of the Vidushaka in this again. And how the tone of the natakam is set with this shloka. It's very beautiful. So Vishranta Vikraha Kataha, everything is an adjective. All the Prathama Vyakti words are all an adjective to Vatseshwara. So here is a comparison between Vatseshwaraha and Kusuma Chapaha. Kusuma Chapa is one Manmatha. சுமத்சேஸ்வரஹா குசுமசாபஹா இவ ஜஸ்ட் லைக் மன்மதா அப்யபைதி. ஹி இஸ் கமிங் ஃபார் வாட் இஸ் ஹி கமிங்? நிஜ மகோத்சவ தர்ஷனாய. பிகாஸ் த வசந்த ரித்து ஹஸ் ஸ்டார்டட். மன்மதோத்சவ மதனோத்சவ இஸ் எ ஃபெஸ்டிவல் தட் இஸ் யூஸ்வலி செலிபிரேட்டட் டியூரிங் தட் வசந்த ரித்து வென் இட் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ நிஜ மகோத்சவ தர்ஷனாய. இஃப் மன்மதா வாண்டட் டு கம் அண்ட் வாட்ச் ஹிஸ் ஓன் உற்சவம் மதனோத்சவம் which happens during Vasanta Ritu, how would it be? That is how this Vatsaraja was. So Udayana is so beautiful, so handsome like Manmatha, and Vatseshwara Nija Mahotsava. So any festival that happens in a kingdom always has the king as the principal, you know, he is like the MC, not MC, how do you say, he is the one who presides over any function that happens in the kingdom. So it is Vatseshwaram Uddishya Kritaha Utsavaha. So Nija Mahotsava Darshanaya. Every word is going to be both for Vatseshwara and for Kusumachapa. So both the Udayana and Manmatha are going to be described with each and every word. So you actually, it is not only Upama, it is a Slesha Anupranita Upama. Slesha means double meaning for each word. Any time you encounter a shloka which has double meaning, that too in such extent, it's easier if you put a tabular column. I won't be doing this for everything, so I just wanted to show you how you can easily put it in, frame it in your mind. For that I did this. So Vishranta Vigraha Kathaha. First let's look at Vatsaraja. How does it go for him? Vigraha is Samaraha or Yuddham. So Vishranta Samara Katha, one who has won over all his enemies. So there is no story of war. All the war stories have all quietened down, and now it is only enjoyment time. So he has set the stage for a Dhira Lalita here, right in the first Vigrahakya. So Vishranta Visheshana, Vishranta Vigraha Kathaha. Now how is it going to Kusuma Chapa? There he is saying Vigraha means his Shariram. Nobody is talking about his shariram here, right? He is anangaha. The katha about his sharira charcha is completely gone, nashtam, because he is anangaha. So Vishranta Vigraha Katha. Next is Ratiman here. It is very easy for Manmatha because his wife's name is Rati. So Ratya Sahitaha Ratiman. For Vatsaraja, for Udayana, Rati means Anuraga, Raktaha. He has an extreme love towards his praja, subjects. He likes his subjects, or he is endearing towards his subjects. Next is Janasya Chitte Vasanne. So the subjects are also in turn showing the king a Vatsalyam, or they like him also. Because the king is very endearing towards the praja, the subjects are also and so janasya chitte api saha vasati raja. The same way for manobhava, he is manobhavaha, manasi bhavati. Any manmata is not a person who comes directly and throws arrows on you, right? The moment you feel that love in your mind, then it means manmata's presence is felt. So saha janasya chitte vasanne, he stays in the minds of people. And priya vasantakaha, the other next adjective, fourth adjective is priya vasantakaha. Here, as far as the natakam is concerned, vasantaka is the name of the vidushaka. So priya sukhrut vasantakaha yasya. Here vasantaha eva vasantakaha alpa, actually not alparte kapratyam, it is what is that? Priyam and the oru idukaga solradhu vasantakaha iti vasantaha eva vasantakaha. So there is no difference between vasanta and vasantaka. Here vasanta means madhumasaha, spring. Vasanta ritu is his favorite, right? Dhanu paushpam maurvi madhukaramayi pancha vishikaha vasantaha samantaha. In Saundarya Lahari he will say vasanta samanto malayamarud ayodhanaratha. So vasanta is the only fellow who will be a companion, constant companion for Manmatha. Priya vasantakaha பரியுத்சுகா சாக்ஷாதேவ நிஜ மகோத்சவ தர்சனாய. He wanted to come and see his own festival Sakshadeva. Paryutsukaha, with a great curiosity, he wanted to see his festival. That his festival also you have to interpret it in two different ways, where you can say Nija Mahotsavaya Madana Utsavam happens during Vasanta Ritu, and Nija Mahotsavam for the Raja is any festival in the kingdom is always with the Raja in mind. And it is the description is also in the Chatushkona or the Chatushpatham, where it is outside the palace. That is where the whole thing starts, the Natakam. So Nija Mahotsava Darshanaya, Sakshadeva Nija Mahotsava Darshanaya Vatseshwaraha Kusumachapaha Iva, like Manmatha Abhyupaiti, he comes. Here the Upama is so beautifully employed in such a manner that the Shungara Rasam, and it starts off the Uddeep, the Vibhava for the Shungara Rasam very beautifully here, right? So Atra Vatseshwarasya Kusuma Chapena Upama Shringara Avasara, because it is the tone or the opportunity for Shungara Rasam. Sarasa Charu Taratam Kamapi Chetas Chamatkarinim Avishkaroti. Avishkaroti, it brings about a Chetas Chamatkarinim. It brings a great Chamatkara to the mind. Because it is beautiful in bringing out that Shringara tone with an Auchityam. Okay. So here, this is an Alankara Auchityam. For Alankara Anauchityam, he gives many examples in his text, in the original text. So we'll go through all four. The first one he says, which is also in your material, is Chandraka's shloka. Khagokshiptaihi antraihi taru shirasi dolaiva rachita shiva atriptahara swapiti ratikhinneva vanita trishartho gomayuhu sarudhiram asim ledhi bahushaha bilanveshi sarpaha hatagaja karagram pravishati. This would have been the perfect example for Bibhatsa Rasam, but for just one upama where it doesn't fit properly. Only that upama. Otherwise, the entire shloka is very beautiful for Bibhatsa. It describes the battlefield after the battle has happened. So after the battle has happened, you imagine the field where more than that Utkritya, Utkritya, which we usually read in Kavya Prakasham and all that, Malati Madhava Shloka. I like the shloka more than that. Even though the Vibhatsa Rasam is there, but still it is much more enjoyable, I feel. So the aftermath of a battlefield, imagine how it will be filled with bodies. And the you know, the birds of prey and the animals of prey are all coming and having a feast there. Right? So khaga ukshiptaihi antraihi taru shirasi dola iva rachita. The first thing is, you find from a distance, after going to the battlefield, you know, you don't need to go to the battlefield. The first thing you see is the trees that are the barren trees that are there on the outer side. That is the first thing that you see, and there you will find many swings. What is a swing here? Khaga ukshiptaihi antraihi. Antram is entrails, all the intestines that the birds have all taken. All the khaga is kaka and vulture, all gridhra and all these birds of prey, they have all thrown ukshiptaihi antraihi. The entrails have all been thrown on taru shirasi, on the tops of the trees. The entrails have all been made like a dola. Dola is a swing. So dola iva khaga ukshiptaihi antraihi dola rachita iva asti tatra. After the tree you approach, you know, the first is the top of the tree you see. Then as you go further towards the battlefield, you will see many she jackals, the female jackals, which are all sleeping under the trees. Okay, Shiva, Triptahara, Swapiti, ரதிகின்னா இவ வனிதா. திஸ் இஸ் தி ஒன்லி பார்ட் தட் இஸ் தி அனௌச்சித்யம். ஓகே, கீப் தட் இன் மைண்ட், பட் வில் கம் டு தட் எக்ஸ்பிளேஷன் லேட்டர். ஸோ சிவா திருப்தாஹாரா, த ஜெகால்ஸ், த ஃபீமேல் ஜெகால்ஸ் ஆர் ஆல் வெரி ஹாப்பிலி சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட், தே ஹவ் ஹேட் தேர் ஃபில். திருப்த ஆஹாரா, ஆஹாரேண திருப்தா சிவா ஸ்வபிதி, இட் இஸ் ஆல் ஸ்லீப்பிங் தேர். நோ, ஆஃப்டர் ஹேவிங் அ குட் ஃபுல் மீல், ஹவு இஸ் இட் ஸ்லீப்பிங்? ரதிகின்னா வனிதா இவ. ரதி கின்னா, ரதி சம்போக, சம்போகாத்து பரம், கின்னா யா வனிதா. ஆஃப்டர் ஹேவிங் அ யூனியன், அ லேடி இஸ் சோ டயர்ட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் அண்ட் ஷீ இஸ் ஸ்லீப்பிங். ஜஸ்ட் லைக் தட் திஸ் சிவா ஆர் திஸ் ஷீ ஜெகால் இஸ் ஸ்ருகாலி சுப்தா ஸ்வபிதி. நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் ஸ்ருஷார்த்தா. தட் மொமெண்ட் இட் செல்ஃப், யூ நோ வாட் ஷுட் பி அ ஸ்ருங்கார ரச பிரதானம் has been brought into you know bibatsarasam, right? So the that which should be used for sambhoga shringaram has been used here in the context of a bibatsarasa. So that is the anauchityam here. Okay, so ratikinna iva vanita trishartaha gomayuhu. But the rest of the shlokam is beautiful. So gomayuhu is shrugalaha, trishartaha, it is suffering from trit is pipasa, from thirst. So the thirsty jackal is searching, it goes and you know licks the sword which has rudhiram. Sir rudhiram asim lady bahushaha, again and again repeatedly it is licking the sword which is stained with blood because it is thirsty, it seems. So trishartaha gomayuhu sir rudhiram asim lady bahushaha. The last one, bila anveshi sarpaha. So next is you go and see the small things, right? You're so close in the battlefield that you can see other things that are moving. So sarpaha. Next is the serpent. The serpent always wants to go and hide itself inside a bilam. Bilam is a hole, right? So bila anveshi sarpaha, a serpent which is searching for a hole to go and hide, what does it do? Hata gaja kara agram pravishati. It enters the trunk of an elephant which is hata, which is dead. So hata gaja kara agram pravishati. It goes and enters into the trunk. Otherwise, it would never go to an elephant, right? So imagine when the elephant is standing, it can never, the snake can never even approach that elephant. Be so afraid of being stamped by the elephant, whereas this sarpaha hatagaja karagram pravishati bilanveshi sarpaha. All of these are fine except for that ratikhinna eva vanita. But in Niti Shatakam he says manishanol lidaha and kalasheshas chandraha surata mridita bala vanita tanimna shobante galita vivavascha artishu naraha. Surata mridita bala vanita, the girl who is after that rati, after the samboga, she actually a little emancipated, that is krisha, krishatvam has happened, tanu, she becomes very thin a little bit after the samboga and she looks beautiful, tanimna shobhante. He takes it as an example for beauty there, and how can you bring it to a place where it is full of bibatsarasam, right? Just that portion is a problem. Anuchita sthana atra, the vritti here is anuchita sthana sthidayaha shivayaha. It's an adjective to the Shiva or the Shrigali. So anuchita sthana sthidayaha, she is standing in a battlefield which is filled with dead bodies. There purusha pishita tripta suptayaha. How is she sleeping? Tripta ahara. What is her aharam? It's not a big banana leaf with items from this side to that side, right? That is not the aharam that she has had. Purusha pishita, mamsam. Purusha mamsam. Tena tripta, tasmata sukta. So because of that, she's sleeping after eating the flesh of any men. How can you compare it to surata keli klanta kanta? Instead of vanita, he in fact uses the word kanta here and says it is, she is an attractive woman ஹூ இஸ் கிளாந்த, ஹூ இஸ் வெரி டயர்ட் ஆஃப்டர் சுரத கேலி ஆஃப்டர் த சம்போகம். சோ சுரத கேலி கிளாந்த காந்தயா விச்சாயா இவ, விச்சாயா இவ ஏவ உபமா. சோ விச்சாயா மீன்ஸ் சௌந்தர்ய ரஹிதம். சிவாயாஹ காந்தயா விச்சாயா, த த how do I say this in English? I'm not able to say it properly. La the pennari and the penninudaya oru saundaryam illadavalaga iruka. She is devoid of the female jackal is devoid of the beauty that the girl possesses. So that is vichhaya is saundarya rahita asti. This upama does not have that beauty. So vaiparityam prakashayati, it in fact shows. So when you look at a ratikhinna vanita, you can't have a bibatsam there. That's why I took the example of tanimna shobhante. Have that in mind and say this is actually more beautiful, and he has used it in a very inappropriate manner, that ratikhinna vanita also will then evoke a bibatsa rasam, which is not desired in most of the kavyams that we read. கரெக்ட். சோ ரகோக்ஷிப்தைஹி அந்த்ரைஹி தரு சிரசி தோலா இவ ரசிதா சிவா திருப்தாஹாரா ஸ்வபிதி ரதிக்கிண்ணேவ வனிதா த்ரிஷார்த்தோ கோமாயுஹு ச ருதிரம் அசிம் லேடி பகுஷஹ விலான்வேஷி சர்பஹ ஹதகஜ கராக்ரம் பிரவிஷதி. கடைசி ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ரொம்ப பிடிச்சது எனக்கு, வெரி நைஸ். அனதர் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஹி கிவ்ஸ் ஃபார் அனௌச்சித்யம் is abhinava vadu malavendrasya, it's another kavi. abhinava vadu roshaswadaha karisha tanunapat asarala jana aslesha kruraha tushara samiranaha galita vibhavasya agnya agnya iva adya dyutihi masrana ravehe virahi vanita vitropam vatra aupamyam vibharti nishakaraha. So it's describing the Shita Kalam here, winter season. During the winter, the Agni is more desirous than the Vayu. So nobody wants the Shita Samiraha. They only want the Agni because it is very cold and they want fire near them. And so the first thing he says is Adya. கரீஷ தனூன பாத்து, கரீஷ இஸ் அந்த விராட்டி, அது பேர் என்ன, கவுடங் யூ யூஸ் அஸ் அ ஃபியூவல் ரைட், தட் இஸ் கால்ட் கரீஷ. அண்ட் தி அக்னி தட் கம்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் தனூன பாத்து. தனூன பாத் இஸ் அ ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் வேர்ட் வேர் தனூனபம் இஸ் கிருதம், தனூன பாத் இஸ் கிருதம் அத்தி இது தனூன பாத் அக்னி. யூ கீப் ஃபீடிங் ghee to it and it keeps eating it, right? The fire keeps eating it. So tanunapat is fire, and the karisha tanunapat, at any point you will find that the fire that comes from that cow dung, the smell of that is more very nice also, more than, you know, burning tires during bhogi. If you burn this vrati, cow dung, then the smell is also very nice, and you like it during winter because it is very cold during winter and you want that fire. He compares it to, he says, karisha tanunapat abhinava vadu rosha aswadaha. It is beautiful that it is enjoyable or endearing. The fire is endearing, like the kopa, rosha, or the anger of a vadhu, a newly wed. Abhinava vadhu, a newly wed, is angry towards her husband, and that kopam, actually the husband likes it. It is that pranaya kopa that is there. So the agni which comes from that cow dung is very endearing, like the newly wed's anger. Next is tushara samiranaha. Tushara, snow, samiranaha, or chilly wind. Tushara samiranaha, the chill wind, is very kruraha, very tough on the body, just like how asarala jana ashlesha kruraha. Asarala, sarala jana is an innocent person. If an innocent person comes and hugs you, it's very nice for us. when a child, for example, no, or the first love and the hug, then it's very nice to experience that. Whereas Asarala Jana, a person who is kapatam, he is not innocent, but he's a dushta, and he comes and tries to hug you, then it is a kruram. It's a very painful hug of a person who is not innocent. So Asarala Jana Aslesha Kruraha Tushara Samiranaha. When it is hot, the wind is very beautiful for the body. It's a soft and caressing wind. Whereas the cool wind during winter, Tushara Samiranaha, it is actually Kruraha, like an Asarala Jana Asleshaha, Dushta Jana Aslesha Iva Alinganamiva, Kruraha Bhavati Samiranaha Tushara Samaye. Galita vibhavasya agnya iva adya dyutihi masrinaha ravehe dyutihi surya's prakasha, the sun's light is masrina, very komalam. It's very, very soft on the body. How is it like a galita vibhavasya agnya iva ravehe dyutihi masrina? The surya's prakasham is very komalam, just like a person who doesn't have any wealth and he is giving an order. So galita vibhavaha agnyam yada dadati tada, there is no prabhavaha, there is no effect for the agnya that a person who does not have any wealth gives. So I'm reminded of that the first shlokam in Nitishatakam. Prabhavaha smayadushitaha abodha upahatascha anye jirnamange subhashitam. Agnya sukhamaradhyaha illa. Prabhavaha smayadushitaha. I can only remember that part. So usually when someone has wealth, aishwaryam, they are filled with garva. Prabhavaha, Prabhu, a person who has wealth. So smayadushitaha, he has garvam. And the way he gives an order will also have a force. Imagine the midday surya. Bodhāraha matsaragrastaha. Right. Bodhāraha matsaragrastaha, prabhavaha smayadushitaha. Bodhāraha, people who know a lot are matsaragrastaha, they are jealousy, they are attacked by jealousy. They have a lot of jealousy towards other person who is saying good things, if it's a scholar. So if it is a person who is a prabhu, if he has a lot of wealth, he has too much of arrogance in him. Abodha upahatascha anye, the rest of the world is completely immersed in ignorance. So jirnamange subhashitam. Imagine his disappointment there. Bhartrihari will say, jirnamange subhashitam. Whatever good things I'm saying, it is just going to get destroyed in my own body. Nobody is going to understand it and live by it. Starts off his text by this. Huh? So there he uses prabhavaha smayadushitaha, where he says the aishwaryam makes a person very garbita, ahankari. And when he gives an order, he also talks with that force. So it has a force among people because people always look up to yasyasti vittam sanarak kulinaha sa shrutavan sa gunajnaha ka sarve gunah kanchanam ashrayanti. So his agnya will have a force. Whereas a person who does not have vibhava, does not have any wealth, galita vibhavasya agnya masrina, komala, it's very, very soft and it doesn't have any effect at all. The same way during winter, Surya has no effect. That's why we are feeling cold always. Because we are going through winter, I'm like, understand it with more effect here. Next is Nishakaraha. How is the Chandra? The moon also does not have too much of effect. Virahi Vanita Vaktra Aupamyam. He is very pale. He's not very bright. Whereas in Sharat Kala, Sharad Jyotsna Shuddham. In Sharat Kalam, there are no clouds, nothing, no fog or anything. So the moonlight can come very clearly and we can receive it. Whereas here, during winter, Nishakaraha, the Chandra, Virahi Vanita Vaktra Aupamyam. விரஹி வனிதா லேடி ஹூ இஸ் இன் விரஹா ஹர் வக்த்ரா த ஃபேஸ் வில் பி வெரி பேல் வாக்த்ரேன ஔபம்யம் விபர்த்தி இட் ஹாஸ் அ சாதிருஷ்யம் டு தட் நவ த ஸ்லோகா சீம்ஸ் வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஹியர் பியூட்டிஃபுல் டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் ஆஃப் விண்டர் நவ வேர் டஸ் க்ஷேமேந்திரா ஃபைண்ட் தி அனௌச்சித்யம் ஹியர் அத்ர கோமள காமினி கோபேன கரீஷ கிருஷானோ சாதிருஷ்யம் சி தட் கோமளத்வம் தட் ஹி யூசஸ் இன் த தேர்ட் லைன் இஸ் வெரி ஆப்ட் இஸ் வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல் தேர் ரைட் So the idea is nice that where the Agni is more dear, even though it hurts, the fire, even though if it hurts, it is very endearing to us. In the same way, the Abhinava Vadhu Rosha, Kamini Kopa, it may be, it is not actually hurting here. She may feel angry, But it is not a hurtful anger. The pranayakopam is always, it's in the Tamil, oodallumba. Oodallungra vaarthaye vandu, it is not, it is called pranayakopam. That is the kopa that you have during in love. That is kamini kopaha. That is komalam. You cannot compare it to krishanu, karisha krishanu. And the word he uses also is not agni or anything else, but he uses tanunapat, where gritam atti, tanunapam atti, it eats the grita. Even that is a harsh term that he uses for that kopa. Kopa anala. Anala might be a better word, right? But karisha tanunapat all evokes a different idea in our mind. It immediately, our mind contracts when we hear that word, right? So Shita Samaya Swadutaya, even though it is very endearing, the Agni is endearing during the winter time, still what happens is Hridaya Samvada Sundaramapi, even though it is beautiful to the mind, Anuchitatvena, here it is not appropriate. He has not used the appropriate words and to describe the Komala Kamini Kopaha. Hence, what happens? Chetasaha Sankochamiva Adadati. As if we are, you know, why is he using this word? There is a sudden aswarasata there in our mind. We are not able to enjoy it for a moment. Okay. Next.
நீங்க சொல்றதுனால நினைக்கிறேன் எனக்கு என்ஜாய் பண்ண முடியாது.
It's actually a very beautiful shloka. Both shlokam, the earlier one and this, at least earlier one, la vandu romba palichana andha surata vanitha onne adara enna adu. I am only reminded of that tanimna shobhante. How can he put it here? Yeah, it's only from the vyutpatti that I can understand that tanunapath is not desirable here. Yeah. Adu.
Ivara inge vrittila he says komalatva taaropam panni பயஸ் பண்ற மாதிரி இருக்கு.
ஆமா. மோர் தென் தட் ஐ திங்க் அந்த தனுவன பாத்துங்கிற விற்பத்தி எடுத்துட்டோம்னா தென் இட் இஸ்
எஸ்
தட்ஸ் வாட் ஐ ஃபீல் இஸ் தி அனௌசித்ய பார்ட் தேர் ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் அகைன் ராஜசேகர ஹிஸ் ஃபேவரட் போயட் சிதா சக்கரம் சந்திரா குசும தனுஷா தக்த வபுஷா கலங்கஸ்தத்ரத்யா ஸ்பிருஷதி மலினாங்கார மலின அங்கார கலனாம் எதேதத் சஜ்ஜோதிஹி தரதலித கற்பூர தவலம் மருத்பிஹி பஸ்ம ஏதத் பிரசரதி விகீர்ணம் திசி திசி ஹியர் ஆல்சோ ஹி சேஸ் தெர் இஸ் அன் அனௌச்சித்யம் வேர் ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் த ஸ்லோகா இட் செல்ஃப் வித் சிதா சிதா சக்கரம் சிதா இஸ் த ஃபியூனரல் பயர் த அரேஞ்ச்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் வுட் தட் யூ கீப் ஃபார் பர்னிங் பாடிஸ் ரைட் தட் இஸ் த சிதா சிதா சக்கரம் சந்திரா ஐ ஹவ் நாட் சீன் எனிபடி டிஸ்கிரைப் சந்திரா ஆஸ் அ சிதா சக்கரம் இட் இஸ் லைக் த சிதா ஆர் ஃபியூனரல் பயர் இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் அ சக்கரம் தட் இஸ் த சந்திரன் சந்திரா இஸ் ஓகே ஐ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் மன்மத கிரியேட்ஸ் அ சந்தாபம் இன் ஆர் பாடி அண்ட் இட் கிரியேட்ஸ் அ பர்னிங் இன் ஆர் இன் தட் அண்ட் ஆல் இஸ் ஃபைன் தக்த வபுஷா குசும தனுஷா தி அட்ஜெக்டிவ் ஹி கிவ்ஸ் வாண்ட்ஸ் டு டிஸ்கிரைப் த விரஹ அவஸ்தா ஃபைன் But it is an amangala suchakatvam. It is a dosha. Right? Why that amangalam comes? Because the chita word is anauchityam here. So every dosha, if you go to the dosha prakaranam in all the Alankara Shastra texts, all of that will have an anauchityam in that, all the anitya doshas. So doshas are of two types, where you have nitya dosha and anitya dosha. Nitya dosha are those that cannot be used at any context. Anitya doshas are those which are anityam only in certain contexts. Like for example, Parushaksharam is an anitya dosha. Parushakshara is a dosha in Shringara Rasa, whereas it is a guna in Veera Rasa or Raudra Rasa. So those that can act as both dosha and guna are called anitya doshas. Okay. Here, according to Kshemendra, even the aspect of dosha arises only because there is an anauchityam. So you have to go back to auchitya and anauchitya. If you understand that very well, then you don't even need to understand dosha separately. Right? Only if you understand the auchityam and anauchityam, can you even understand why he has enlisted all those doshas there? Pada, padamsha, padagata, vakyagata, rasagata, gunagata, everything he will be saying. Right? Dosha chapter will be much more than the guna chapter. So chita chakram chandraha kusuma dhanushaha, dagda vapushaha kusuma dhanushaha, chandraha chita chakram. Chandraha, the moon, is like the funeral pyre of kama, manmatha, kusuma dhanushaha, whose vapus, the body, has been dagda, it has already been burnt. Where basma vashesham madanam chakara. Shiva opened his third eye and burnt his body. So dagda vapushaha, kusuma dhanushaha, chita chakram chandraha. So where he puts the bodies and burns, that is, he puts people into a series of difficulties. Kama, manmatha, makes people go through a series of difficulties, right? And he shows this chandra, which is supposed to be an uddipana vibhavam. It actually, he describes it as a chita, a funeral pyre. Kalankaha, tatratyaha, kalankaha. You know, that black thing that is there in that chandra is actually the coal. Malina angara kalanam sprishati. It is almost equal to, sprishati means it is not touching, but it is described as, it is equal to that black coal that is there in the chita. All the indhanam items, the fuel items that you put, right? So it is like an angara coal. Yad etat sajyotihi. So the chandra which spreads jyotis everywhere. It spreads a light everywhere, kiranam everywhere, right? Sajyotihi yad etat. Tat dara dalita karpura dhavalam asti. So it is like the karpura dhavalam. It is very white, like the karpura churnam. Dara dalita, the sharp dalita cut karpura churnam, which is very white. You know, you use for nirajanam, that karpuram. So it has the sajyotihi, the chandra kirana is like the karpura. It is white like the karpuram. And marudbihi etat prasarati. See, it is being spread everywhere. Dishi dishi vikirnam prasarati. Sajyotihi dishi dishi prasarati. The jyotis of the chandra prasarati, it spreads in all directions. Vikirnam, as it is as if this white karpura has been made into bhasma and the wind is just blowing them in all directions. So you have the chita of chandra, and the kalankam is the coal, and you have burnt the karpuram there, and the bhasma that comes out of it, the ashes that come out of this chita, have been spread in all directions by Marut. Okay, the description is more of a bibatsam here than any virahatapam. I don't understand. Okay, atrapi. How can Rajashekara even write shlokas like this, and Kshemendra just picks up all those shlokas? It's very nice. I want to read the original now. Anyway, atrapi anandi sudha as avasyandava. Avasyanda. Avasyanda na chotrad. Yeah, okay. Soaking with ananda. Ananda sudha avasyanda sundarasya indoho. This is an adjective to Indu, chandra, who is Sundara, beautiful, because he is dripping with Sudha, nectar, Ananda. Ananda, Sudha, Anandi, Sudha, Avasyanda, Sundaraha. He is so beautiful because he just drips with the nectar of happiness. So the moment you see the Chandra, you feel happy about it. Tadrisha Chandrasya Chita Chakratvam. Here he says Chita Chakram is a Rupaka Alankara he uses. So Chandraha Chita Chakram. So that Rupaka Alankara does not fit properly. Anuchitataya, it is not appropriate. And Karna Katukam, it is very harsh to the ear. The moment we hear Chita Chakram Chandraha, so it means the Nayaka or the Nayika is going to die. That is the first imagery that we will get from this. Right, so atankam iva atanoti. Atankam is ashubha chintanam or atrasam abhayam. It creates that amangala suchakam, right? The moment you hear chita, so you don't want to hear such words. That doesn't strike a good chord. So chita chakram chandraha kusuma dhanushaha dagdha vapushaha kalankaha tatratyaha sprishati malina angara kalanam. Yadetat sajyotihi daradalita karpura davalam marudbihi bhasma yetat prasarati vikirnam dishi dishi. Okay. Next, he actually recaps. Maybe Kshemendra himself feels that I have given too many anauchitya examples. Let me give one auchitya example and conclude. And he says, yaha arthahatu hridaya sambadi, that which is very close to the heart, or it speaks the same words in the same frequency as the sahridaya. Saha yadi anauchitya sparsha lesha rahitaha, double negative, auchitya abhava abhava. So anauchitya rahitaha, that which is devoid of any impropriety, that is that which is which does not have even a little bit of anauchityam. Tada, then it becomes more beautiful. Adhikataram alankara shobham pushnati. It gains or it nurtures because of the beauty in the alankara. Okay. Yatha karpatikasya shitena udghrishitasya masha shimivat chinta arnave majjataha shantagnim sputitadarasya dhamataha krukrama kantasya me nidra kvapi vimanita iva daita santajya duram gata satpatra pratipaditeva vasudha nakshiyate sharvari. The artham here, what he is trying to say is satpatra pratipadita iva vasudha, this bhumi, if she attains a proper satpatra. Satpatra is the perfect recipient for ruling this country. If there is a proper raja, satpatra pratipadita vasudha nakshiyate. Bhumi will not come to a very bad state if it is in the responsibility of a good ruler, right? 1 minute. I'm sorry, I have to cut short. I will deal with the shloka next class. Okay. Ainama. Kamakshi, any doubt?
Shloka ninga apra explain panna paril sir.
Yeah, I will explain it next class. Okay. Sure.